Let's begin by doing some more numerical problems on continuity. Look at question number 22 of the exercise. Here the function fx has been defined as 3ax plus b for x greater than 1 is equals to 1 for x equals to 1 and 5ax minus 2b for x less than 1. You have been given the function is continuous at the point x equals to 1. Find the values of a and b. Now, since the point is continuous at x equals to 1, let's find out the value of the function at 1. And the value of function at 1 is given equals to 1. Now, since the function has different definitions about the point x equals to 1, to the right side of 1, it is defined by 3ax plus b. This will be used in finding the right hand limit. Where for the left side of 1, it is defined by 5ax minus 2b. So, it will be used in finding the left hand limit. So, let's find the limits extending to 1 negative f of x, that is the left hand limit, and left hand limit will be given by limit extending to 1 negative, and the function fx will be replaced here by 5ax minus 2b, and when you write x as 1 here, it becomes 5a minus 2b. Now let us find the right hand limit extending to 1 positive f of x. So, right hand limit extending to 1 plus, the function here will be replaced by 3ax minus b, 3ax plus b, and when you substitute x as 1, this becomes 3a plus b. Now, since the function is given to be continuous at x equals to 1, that means the right hand limit, the left hand limit and x the value of function, all three has to be equal. So, equating them, we get these two equations, 5a minus 2b must be equals to 1, the value of function, and the right hand limit, that is 3a plus b, must also be equals to 1. Now simplifying this equation, solving them simultaneously, that is, we get the value of a and b. A turns out to be 3, b will turn out to be 2. Let's move on to the next sum. Examining the continuity of this function, x into sine of 1 upon x at point x not equals to 0 and is equals to 0 at point x equals to 0 for the continuity at point x equals to 0. Now here again, the point of where the continuity has to be checked is x equals to 0. So the value of function at 0 is given equals to 0. Now we have to find out the limit of the function x tending to 0 f of x. This I can replace as limit x tending to 0 g of x into h of x, where g of x I have defined as x and h of x has been defined as sine 1 upon x. Now children, you know that sine x is a bounded function. It has value between minus 1 and 1 for all x belonging to real number. Therefore, the sine 1 upon x value will also be lie between 1 and minus 1 for all x belonging to 1 except for x equals to 0. That means sine 1 upon x is a bounded function having values between minus 1 and 1 for x not equals to 0. This means to the right neighborhood of 1, sorry, right neighborhood of 0 and right and the left neighborhood of 0, it is a bounded function having value between minus 1 and 1. So the limit x tending to 0 of g of this becomes 0 g of x into h of x will be nothing but 0 into a finite value between minus 1 and 1, and 0 multiplied with any finite value will give you the result 0. Now you see the limit x tending to 0 is 0 and the value of function at point 0 is also 0. So both are equal. So this function becomes continuous at point x equals to 0. Now moving on to the next sum. Finding the value of lambda, the function has been defined as lambda times x square minus 2x for x less than equals to 0 and as 4x plus 1 if x is greater than 0. We have to, and the function is given continuous at point x equals to 0. So let us find out the value of function at the point of continuity. What is the point of continuity? 0. So what is the value of x equals to to 0, the f equal to 0 will be given by this expression, and when you put x as 0, we get lambda into 0, turns out to be 0. Now, what is the limit for the function? Limit for the function tending to x 0 plus. Which function will be replaced by 0 plus here? The 0 plus means 4x plus 1. So, when you write 4x plus 1 here and find the limit, it turns out to be 1. That is 4 into 0 plus 1, that is 1. Now, I find out the right left hand limit now for x tending to 0 negative. That will be given by the function lambda x square minus 2x. And when you substitute x as 0 here, we get lambda into 0, that is 0. Now, what do you find here? That the limit x tending to 0 negative, that is the left hand limit of the function fx, is turning out not to be equals to limit x tending to 0 plus, the right hand limit of the function. So the function has a non-removal discontinuity. It is discontinuous, so any value of lambda will not make it continuous. So lambda cannot take up any value. For any value of lambda, the function will not be continuous at x equals to 0.